వీళ్ళిద్దరు ఇక్కడ దాక్షాయణి అని కాతి అనే వాళ్ళు ఇద్దరు కూడా ఎంబీఏ కంప్లీట్ చేశారు. వాళ్ళ తాతగారు కౌత లలిత మనోహర్ గారు అని చెప్పి హైదరాబాద్ లో ఉండేవారు. ఆయన నిత్యం రామాయణం రెగ్యులర్ గా చదువుతుండేవారు. ఆయన ఎన్నిసార్లు చదివారో నాకైతే తెలీదు. ఆయన ఇంటికి వెళ్ళి చూస్తే ఎటు చూసినా రామాయణం పుస్తకాలు ఈ చిన్న సైజు నుంచి ఇంత పెద్ద సైజు దాకా ఉండేవి పుస్తకాలు. అలాంటి వంశంలో పుట్టిన ఈ చిన్నారులు ఇద్దరు వాళ్ళు కూడా ఆ రామాయణాన్ని చదివి దాన్ని అర్థం చేసుకుని ఇవాళ లైఫ్ లో ఎలా వాడచ్చు, దాన్ని ఎలా మన దాన్ని రిలేట్ చేయొచ్చు అన్న దాని మీద మన అందరి ముందుకి తీసుకురాబోతున్నారు. సో మనందరం దాన్ని చూసి విని మనం ఎలా దీన్ని పాటించవచ్చు అన్నది తెలుసుకుందాం అందరం కూడాను. సో ఓవర్ టు బోత్ ఆఫ్ యూ మా.
అందరికి నమస్కారములు. విత్ ద బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ పెటర్నల్ గ్రాండ్ పేరెంట్స్ తుమ్ములూరి శ్రీ శివరామ కృష్ణయ్య గారు అండ్ శ్రీమతి బాలా త్రిపుర సుందరి గారు అండ్ అవర్ మెటర్నల్ గ్రాండ్ పేరెంట్స్ శ్రీ కౌత లలిత మనోహర్ గారు అండ్ శ్రీమతి కామేశ్వరి గారు, వీ వుడ్ లైక్ టు బిగిన్ దిస్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ విత్ అ ఫ్యూ శ్లోకాస్.
గజాననం భూతగణాది సేవితం కపిత్తజంభూఫలసారభక్షితం ఉమాసుతం శోకవినాశకారణం నమామి విఘ్నేశ్వర పాద పంకజం.
మేము స్క్రీన్ షేర్ చేయాలి, మాకు ఒకసారి ఇస్తారా ఆప్షన్?
శ్రుతి స్మృతి పురాణానాం ఆలయం కరుణాలయం నమామి భగవత్పాదం శంకరం లోక శంకరం. యస్యాత్మ భూతస్య గురోః ప్రసాదాత్ అహం విముక్తోస్మి శరీర బంధాత్ సర్వోపదేష్టు పురుషోత్తమస్య తస్యాంగ్రి పద్మం ప్రణతోస్మి నిత్యం. రామాయ రామభద్రాయ రామచంద్రాయ వేదసే రఘునాథాయ నాదాయ సీతాయాః పతయే నమః. కూజంతం రామ రామేతి మధురం మధురాక్షరం ఆరుహ్య కవితాశాఖాం వందే వాల్మీకి కోకిలం శ్లోకసార సమాకీర్ణం సర్గ కల్లోల సంకులం కాండగ్రాహ మహామీనం వందే రామాయణార్ణవం అంజనానందనం వీరం జానకీశోకనాశనం కపీశమక్షహంతారం వందే లంకావయంకరం. We are blessed to give this samarpanam, Ramayanam Nitya Parayanam, at the feet of His Holiness Sri 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 Kanchi Kamakoti Pithadhipati Swamivari. Swamivari ki namaskaramulu. Swamivari aasisulato ee program shubharambham chestunnamu. This program has been titled Ramayanam Nitya Parayanam, meaning daily recitation of Ramayanam. We shall speak in English for everyone's convenience. Charitam Raghunadasya Shatakoti Pravistaram ఏకైక అక్షరం పుంసాం మహాపాతక నాశనం. ద లైఫ్ స్టోరీ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ రామ హాస్ అ వాస్ట్ ఎక్స్పాన్స్, దట్ ఈస్ ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ వర్డ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ లెటర్ ఇస్ కేపబుల్ ఆఫ్ డిస్ట్రాయింగ్ ఈవెన్ ద గ్రేటెస్ట్ సిన్స్. చరితం రఘునాథస్య శతకోటి ప్రవిస్తరం ఏకైక అక్షరం పుంసాం, దిస్ వన్ లెటర్ ఇస్ ఇన్ మహాపాతక నాశనం టు డిస్ట్రాయ్ మెనీ సిన్స్. వేదవేద్యే పరే పుంసి జాతే దశరథాత్మజే వేద ప్రాచేతసా దాసీ సాక్షాద్ రామాయణాత్మ. వేదవేద్యే పరే పుంసి, దట్ ఇస్ ద వన్ హూ ఇస్ నోన్ త్రూ ద వేదాస్ ఇస్ ద సుప్రీం బీయింగ్. నౌ దిస్ సుప్రీం బీయింగ్ డిసెండెడ్ టు ఎర్త్ యాజ్ లార్డ్ శ్రీరామ. వేదవేద్యే పరే పుంసి జాతే దశరథాత్మజే, దిస్ సుప్రీం బీయింగ్ హూ డిసెండెడ్ టు ఎర్త్ యాజ్ లార్డ్ రామ వాజ్ బోర్న్ యాజ్ ద కింగ్ ఆఫ్ దశరథ. Now, when he was born as the son of King Dasharatha, the Vedas themselves took the form of Valmiki's expression as Ramayana. Veda Prachetasa Dasi Sakshad Ramayanatmana. Now, according to this, the ultimate goal of the Vedas is to understand the Supreme Being or the Self. To summarize this, we can say that daily recitation of Ramayana is an equivalent to studying the Vedas. The inner meaning of the divine name Rama, simply put, is
when one utters the first letter ra, all the sins come out of their body. And when one utters ma, these sins are burnt and destroyed. Such is the significance and the magnificence of this two-lettered mantra, ra, ma. Now, what is the meaning of Ramayanam? Rama plus Ayanam simply translates to Rama's walk. Now, what is special about Rama's walk? Lord Rama always walked on Satyam and Dharma. Rama showed how to love a father, a brother, a mother, how to respect a woman, how to be a student, how to talk, how to keep promises. In short, basically, how to be a human being. Ramayanam shows that Paramatma will always protect us when we follow Satyam, Dharmam, and we should never part with it, no matter what the situation is. Ramayanam is basically a guide for a human to lead dharmic life. Now, the importance of this epic can be depicted in this shloka. Yavat stasyanti girayaha saritascha mahitale tavat Ramayana kata lokeshu prachadishyati. So, as long as Ramayana is recited or studied or preached or heard, it is said that this earth will be balanced with mountains, rivers and cordial relations between humans. By the grace of God and the blessings of our parents, we completed the recitation of Ramayana, Valmiki Ramayana Moolam, consisting of 24,000 shlokas. Ramayana consists of numerous examples of the conduct of an individual right through all facets of life, right from childhood to adulthood and through old age. Now, we were blessed to have the opportunity of reciting the Charma Sargas of the Yuddha Kanda, which is the Pattabhisheka Sarga, under the auspice of our maternal late grandfather, Brahmashri Kauta Lalita Manohar Garu. Now, our grandfather, he had the divine blessings of Sri Paramacharya to have completed Ramayana Parayana for almost 76 times throughout his entire life. Now, we would like to begin with a few divine experiences that we had in the due course of our Parayana. For us, life became more disciplined once we began our Nitya Parayana of Srimad Ramayana. To give you an example, we woke up at 5 in the morning and that became a routine for us at home. And in due course, we used to feel void on those days when we couldn't do our daily recitation because of some of the other worldly obligations. We also noticed how positivity and success in various forms was imbibed in our lives. We won awards at college, or we had the confidence of taking up new challenges. And we also had more clarity in our thinking before we did anything in our lives. Now, why or how can this happen? Anyone would think. All of you have heard of this shloka. Yatra yatra Raghunatha Kirtanam, tatra tatra Kritamasta Kanjalim, Vashpavari Paripurna Lochanam, Marutim Namata Rakshasantapam. Now, all of us know the shloka. Wherever and whenever Ramanamam is chanted, Yatra yatra Raghunatha Kirtanam, Lord Hanuman is present to destroy the enemies within us, such as anger, fear, stress, and other Arishad Vargas. Tatra tatra Kritamasta Kanjalim, Vashpavari Paripurna Lochanam, Marutim Namata Rakshasantapam. Now, Lord Hanuman is the Utsahamurti, and just a mere invocation of his image can drive out any negative thoughts that we have or any fear that we have in our minds. Even in Sundara Kanda, in Sarga 39, Devi Sita says the following words to Hanuman after giving her Chudamani. Tvam asmin karya niryoge pramanam hari sattama Hanuman yatna mastaya dukkha kshayakaro bhava tasya chintayato yatno dukkha kshayakaro bhave. Now, this shloka is actually considered as a mantra for Karya Siddhi. Here, the goddess herself places her belief in Hanuman that he would certainly be successful in conveying her inquiries to Sri Rama. Now, it is important for us to know the meaning of this shloka. Tvam asmin karya niryoge pramanam hari sattama. O Hanuman, the best among monkeys, you are capable of fulfilling this task. Hanuman yatna mastaya dukkha kshayakaro bhava tasya chintayato yatno dukkha kshayakaro bhavet. O Hanuman, you can become the one who can remove my misfortunes by employing your effort. And if one thinks of you carefully, and if I think of it carefully too, your effort will become the one which can remove my misfortunes. when Devi Sita herself places such a high conviction in Lord Hanuman for Karya Siddhi, because he has to give her Chudamani to Sri Rama. Now she places conviction in Hanuman for Karya Siddhi. Aren't we as humans, as mortals with limited capacity, supposed to seek divine help at all times? Even in Lalita Ashtotram, the Namam, Bhavana Matra Santushta Hridayaye Namo Namaha, this explains that the goddess is delighted just by a mere thought or bhavana of her by the devotee. This holds true to all gods and goddesses that we worship. In Sanshipta Ramayana, also known as the Bala Ramayana, it forms the first sarga of the Balakanda. The importance of reading Ramayana is expressed in this shloka. Idam pavitram papagnam punyam vedaischa sammitam yapateed ramacharitam sarva papai pramuchyate. Idam pavitram papagnam punyam vedaischa sammitam. Ramayana is a legendary epic and pride of India's heritage. It is so holy, sin eradicating. Pavitram idam pavitram papagnam. It is also merit endowing and in accordance to the teachings of Veda. Punyam vedaischa sammitam. Yapateed ramacharitam. Whoever reads Ramayana, sarva papai pramuchyate. He will be liberated from all the sins. And also, by reading which, a human will lead a very long life. He will be blessed with sons, grandsons, and after enjoying worldly comforts, he will be adored in heaven even after the life on earth. Etadakhyana mayushyam patan ramayanam naraha saputra pautra saganaha pretya swarge mahiyate. He will enjoy sons, grandsons, all worldly comforts, and then he will be adored in heaven. Our great sages and ancestors have laid an easy path for us to reach the feet of the Lord. When we are given this sense of direction, isn't it our duty to put our efforts and follow the footsteps of these Mahatmas to attain the supreme goal? Our Hindu tradition has a practice of writing Ramakoti. All of us are already aware of the same. Going back to Setu Bandhanam, we know that the mighty Vanaras wrote the holy name Sri Rama on each stone. And these stones floated on the waters of the Hindu Mahasamudra, wherein it formed the Setu bridge to bring back Devi Sita. Now, have you ever wondered what this is symbolic of? Now, when we were discussing with our parents, they gave us a beautiful connection of this instance in Ramayana and our life. Now, here the Vanaras, with complete hope and belief in the Ramanamam, they built a bridge of stones on an ocean, which is otherwise impossible. Now compare these stones with our hearts and our life as this sagara. Now if Ramanamam is so powerful that it helped a heavy object float in the waters, then it can certainly lift our heavy hearts from the burdens of this worldly issues if we ensure to write that name, Sri Ramanamam, in our hearts forever. Mahaswami also encouraged everyone to write Ramakoti and make it a daily habit. So I ensure all of you that it will definitely help you even if you do the same. Now moving on, I would like to talk about a small shloka in a small humorous way as well. There is this shloka. Pratah kale dyuta prasangeshu madhyanne stri prasangeshu cha sayankale chora prasangeshu kalo gacchati dhimatam. Now this shloka, It has different meanings to it. Now, Pratakkale Dyuta Prasangeshu. Now, what does this mean? A learned person should think about playing dice in the morning. But what does it otherwise mean? It means reading Mahabharata in the morning. That is what it is symbolic of. Madhyanne Stri Prasangeshu cha. You should talk about women in the afternoon. Otherwise, it is also talking about Stri Prasanga, which comes in Ramayana. And the story of Sita should be discussed in the afternoon. Sayankale Chora Prasangeshu. Now, this discusses the acts of a thief in the evening. What is it otherwise symbolic of? It means that Srimad Bhagavatam should be read in the evening, which discusses at length about the Navanita Chora Prasanga or the Leelas of Sri Bhagavan Krishna. Kalo Gacchati Dhimatam. Now, this is the way the way life is led by wise people, even in some families during these days. So please ensure that you read at least any epic or Purana that will definitely help you in any obstacle that comes in your life. Now, there are numerous hidden gems in the ocean of Ramayana that all of us can learn from and obtain joy and confidence. These are some of the gems that we wanted to discuss. You know, how Sri Rama is the most supreme Bhagavan. How we as human beings should possess our attires. Apart from that, you know, how Lord Hanuman, like my sister had mentioned, he's the Utsahamurti, and how he can help us overcome our fears. How we should behave as human beings with our brothers, siblings, and other relatives. And how as women, we should learn from Devi Sita, who is an epitome of greatness. In Yuddhakanda, Lakshmana uses various astras to kill Indrajit, who is the son of Ravana, but in vain. He utters a lot of shlokas, but he's still not able to kill Indrajit. Then Lakshmana pulls out an arrow, utters the shloka at complete surrender, and at Rama's feet. He says, Dharmatma Satya Sandascha Ramo Dasiradir Yati Paurishecha Pratidvandvaha Sharainam Jahiravanim. He takes a very powerful divine arrow, aims it at Indrajit, and says, O divine arrow, if Rama is truthful and righteous, Dharmatma Satya Sandascha Ramo Dasiradir Yati Paurishecha Pratidvandvaha Sharainam Jahiravanim. You must go and kill Indrajit now if Rama is truthful and righteous. Now, Lakshmana, who is an embodiment of such strength, he had such strong conviction in Rama. He sought refuge in him and he was able to kill Indrajit in an instant. In another instance, another quality of Rama is depicted. In Yuddhakanda, Vibhishana comes to Rama and he seeks Sharanagati, but he faces opposition from everyone in Rama's camp. Then the Lord himself vows, telling everyone, Sakrudeva Prapannaya Tava Smitichi Yachate Abhayam Sarvabhutebhyo Dadami Etat Vratam Mama. Sakrudeva Prapannaya Tava Smitichi Yachate. He whoever is seeking refuge in me just once, telling me, I am yours, Tava Smitichi Yachate Abhayam Sarvabhutebhyo Dadami Etat Vratam Mama. I will give him assurance of protection against all types of beings. Dadami Etat Vratam Mama. This is my solemn pledge and my promise. Now, this above verse is also known as the Charma Shloka of Valmiki Ramayana. Once a jiva or a human takes, you know, shelter in Supreme Lord Rama, he has no need to worry about anything because the Lord himself has given a promise that he will take care of us and from all kinds of samsaric fears. So to feel this bliss of being in a loving relation with a Supreme One, a devotee should always recite the Sharanagati Mantra at the end of their daily prayer. As humans, we should always seek refuge at his divine feet in order to sail through the samsara sagara. After all, the shloka goes, Daiva deenam jagat sarvam, mantra deenam tu daivatam, ye mantra brahmana deenam, brahmano mama daivatam. Daiva deenam jagat sarvam, the entire creation is under the control of the God. That God is bound by mantras, mantra deenam tu daivatam. Ye mantra brahmana deenam. These mantras are under the control of brahmanas. Brahmano mama daivatam. Those brahmanas are equivalent to gods. So when Lord Krishna himself says brahmano mama daivatam, we as brahmanas should help and develop that eligibility to serve the divine Lord at least and at least fulfill the duties of this human birth. The supremacy of a Brahmana is powerfully explained by sage Vasishta to Vishwamitra. When, you know, Vishwamitra goes to Vasishta and he wants to take away the divine cow Kamadevi from Vasishta's ashrama. So, to subdue Vishwamitra's vanity, he says, Kwachate Kshatriya Balam, Kwacha Brahma Balam Mahat, Pashya Brahma Balam Divyam, Mama Kshatriya Pansana. Now, what is he saying? Where does your Kshatriya strength stand when compared to the great power of a Brahmana? Kvachate Kshatriya Balam, Kvacha Brahma Balam Mahatir. Behold my divine Brahmanical power born out of my tapas. Pashya Brahma Balam Divyam, Mama Kshatriya Pamsana. Now he puts forth his Brahmadandam, which consumes all the missiles and the entire army of Vishwamitra. Now we must understand that us being as Brahmanas, it is our foremost duty to fully accomplish our dharmic duties. And if we should always keep the Supreme One in our minds, as we also know, Rama is also known as Vigrahavan Dharmaha. He is the Supreme Lord, the Lord Sri Rama, and he is the embodiment of Dharma. Now moving on, our grandfather always used to tell us an anecdote from Ananda Ramayana. and it is composed by Valmiki in another Kalpa. There is one instance which talks about how behavior is molded by the attire that we possess. Now this is also explained in Sundarakanda. This gem is taken from Sundarakanda. Here it is in Ashokavana when Ravana approaches Devi Sita numerous times. He persuades her to marry him but walks away with his wish unfulfilled every time. So he thinks, okay, I have a plan wherein I will assume the form of Sri Rama and approach Sita assuming that his wish will be fulfilled. However, the moment Ravana assumes Rama's form, he is bound by the Ekapatni Vratam of Sri Rama and he walks away from Sita. How beautiful is that? Now, we can also relate another instance to this. In the fight between Sugriva and Vali, what does Rama ask? He tells Sugriva, wear a garland because it will be a mark of differentiation in order for me to kill Vali. We can also understand that this means the importance of wearing something like a necklace or a chain around our neck. What does it invoke? It invokes God's grace much easier and we can become closer to him. So all of us must ensure that we do these, we should uphold our culture and make sure that we wear something around our neck without leaving it bare. So such is the impact of an attire on the person wearing it. Therefore, wearing a traditional or a sampradaya dress will definitely prove fruitful and it will also bring divinity within us. Now, there are innumerable lessons that we can learn from Ramayana. We have mentioned many instances about the power of Lord Hanuman and how he is a source of everlasting strength and support. In Treta Yuga, during the Rama Ravana Yuddha, as a mark of respect to that Brahmastra launched by Indrajit, Rama and Lakshmana appear to become unconscious. They are not unconscious, but they just appear to become unconscious in the battlefield. Many mighty Vanaras are injured, including the great Jambavan. Now, to assess this army's position, Vibhishana, along with Hanuman, go to the battlefield. And there they find Jambavan injured. And upon seeing Vibhishana, he inquires about the welfare of Hanuman. That is, Jambavan asks Vibhishana, how is Hanuman doing? So this comes as a surprise to Vibhishana because he was not inquiring about great warriors like Rama and Lakshmana. Now this is explained through this. Jambavan's inquiry is, Asmin jivati viretu hatamapya hatam balam hanumat yunjita prane jivantopi mrittavayam. If that great Hanuman, brave Hanuman is surviving, the whole army, even if it is killed, is unhurt. That is, on the other hand, if Hanuman has given up his life, Hanumat yunjita prane jivantopi mrittavayam, even if Hanuman has given up his life, we are all dead, even though we are living. But Hanuman was not, he did not feel very prideful about this. Tato vriddham upagamya niyamenaadhya vadayat grihya jambavata padau Hanuman marutatmajaha. Hanuman, the son of wind god, he then approaches, Jambavan, and he offers his salutation by grasping the feet of the Jambavan with devotion. Now this expresses that he is not filled with pride that Jambavan asked about him. It is expressing that no matter what position one holds, they need to show respect to elders, even if they symbolize Jnana Vrittaha or Vayo Vrittaha. Even in Dwapara Yuga, we see in Mahabharata about this inherent power that Lord Hanuman has. He blesses Arjuna during the Kurukshetra war by merely being present on the flag of Arjuna's chariot. That is, he's giving him strength to face his inner enemies. How do you think Arjuna could face so many warriors in tough times? With Krishna as his charioteer and Hanuman who is already adorning his flag, Arjuna had the collective strength to march ahead. As we witness this greatness of Hanuman through all these yugas, our belief in this great messenger of Rama, it will always promise us safety, success, and that willpower to face anything that comes in front of us in this Kali Yuga. Now moving on, there's another noteworthy message in Ramayana and it is the portrayal of brotherly love and sibling relations. Now this is between the sons of Dasharatha who were considered the best among men. Now they were like the four Vedas, independent yet interdependent on each other. In Yuddha Kanda, Rama laments over the uncertain condition of Lakshmana when he falls unconscious after being struck by Ravana's arrow. And speaking from his heart, Rama then says the following words on brotherly love. Deshe deshe kalatrani, deshe deshe cha bandavaha. Tam tu desham na pashyami, yatra brata sahodaraha. He says, wives may be found anywhere and everywhere, and kinsmen too can be had anywhere. Deshe deshe kalatrani, deshe deshe cha bandavaha. Tam tu desham na pashyami, yatra brata sahodaraha. I, however, see no place where a real brother like you, Lakshmana, can be had. Now, what can we understand from this shloka? It signifies that the relationship between children from the same womb of a mother cannot be replaced by any other person in their life. Just like how the night follows a day, the sun's rays succeed its radiance, and how a devotee pursues the Lord endlessly, Rama's brothers were always ever loyal to him. And there's another instance. When Rama goes to the forest, Bharata denies the kingship of Ayodhya and says the following words. Twameva Raja Dharmagya Iti Ramam Vacho Bravit. What does he say? He says, you are the knower of righteousness and you alone should be the king. Which means that he's saying when the elder brother is alive, the younger brother is prohibited from ruling a kingdom. Now this is the respect that he has for an elder brother, and it is highlighted in the context. Twameva Raja Dharmagya Iti Ramam Vacho Bravit. Now there's also another instance that I want to draw in this regard. This is the one where Lakshmana insists on accompanying his elder brother to the forest. And he tells, I will walk ahead of you, always armed with a bow. He says, without you, I do not wish to ascend to heaven. And without you, I do not wish to seek godhood. Without you, I do not crave the rulership of this world. He tells, I will always be with you. Even though you're going to the forest, I will come with you and I will protect you over there as well. There are many examples that can be handpicked from Ramayana, which will portray 1,000 incarnations of closeness, warmth, and loyalty between siblings. All of us, we must always understand this, and we should have cordial relations with our siblings as well.
Ramayanam is also said to be Sitayah Charitam Mahat, which means it depicts the glorious story of Devi Sita, who is the personification of a Pativrata. Now, to highlight this pure, virtuous, and the strong quality of a woman in this Hindu tradition, Devi Sita is a vital example to learn from, especially to inculcate those fundamental habits which are outlined in our Dharma. During their departure to the forest, while crossing the river Ganga, Sita prays that upon their return to Ayodhya after 14 years, she will offer a lakh of cows, and she will, you know, she will offer a lakh of cows to the Brahmanas. She will also worship all the Devatas and also all the Tirthas around River Ganga for the welfare of the family and also for the kingdom of Ayodhya itself. This shows her modesty and the nature of concern that she has to the place that she is belonging to. Pativratam is the penance of a wife as a Sahadharma Charini. Now this is a subject that is rich in love and devotion towards one's husband. It can be understood from Sita's love for Rama on many occasions through Ramayana. Ramasya Daita Bharya Nityam Prana Samahita Janakasya Kulejata Deva Mayeva Nidmita Sarva Lakshana Sampanna Narinam Uttama Vaduhu Sitapya Rugata Ramam Shashinam Rohini Yatha. Even Sita, the daughter-in-law of Dasharatha and Rama's beloved wife, she is always well-disposed. Ramasya Daita Bharya Nityam Prana Samahita, being born in the family of Janaka. And she is created by a divine, you know, marvel. She was endowed with all good characteristics and she was considered to be a crown jewel among women. Sarva Lakshana Sampanna Narina Muttama Vaduhu. She was considered as the most supreme woman among everyone. She who looked like the Lord's own reflection. Sitapya Nugata Ramam Shashinam Rohini Yatha. She always followed her husband Lord Sri Rama, just as how Rohini followed the moon god. In Sundara Kanda, Devi Sita's praiseworthy nature is again highlighted when she tells the Rakshasa woman in Ashokavana, they keep persuading her, marry Ravana, they keep persuading her. Then she tells this shloka, Dinova Rajya Hinova Yome Bhatta Same Guruho. Tam nitya manurakta asmi yatha surya yatha suryam suvachala
దీనోవా రాజ్యహీనోవా ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ హి ఇస్ హెల్ప్లెస్ ఆర్ ఈవెన్ వితౌట్ ద కింగ్డమ్ యోమే భర్త సమే గురు హూఎవర్ ఇస్ మై హస్బెండ్ హి అలోన్ ఇస్ మై గురు తం నిత్యం అనురత్తాస్మి యథా సూర్యం సువర్చల జస్ట్ లైక్ సువర్చల విత్ ద సన్ గాడ్ ఐ యామ్ ఆల్వేస్ ఫాండ్ ఆఫ్ మై హస్బెండ్ She also says that she will follow Rama just as Sachi Devi with Indra, Arundhati with Vasishta, Rohini with Chandra, Lobamudra with Agastya, and as Savitri with Satyavanta. Keeping in mind the virtues of these great personalities, Sita Devi observed her Pativrata Dharma. Now, in this modernized world, it is our duty as women to uphold and preserve this Pativrata Dharma and also to preserve the purity and dignity of being born as a woman. Now, you must have heard of this shloka. Ahalya Draupadi Sita Tara Mandodari Tada Panchakanya Smaren Nityam Mahapataka Nashanam. Now, let us remember these five Pativratas. Ahalya, Draupadi, Sita, Tara, Mandodari. Now, we should remember them regularly as their character can provide strength to get rid of all sins and ill feelings. Now, this shloka is recited early in the morning upon waking up. Now, because of these women who are pious characters, they are known as Pratasmaraniyulu. As to the focus on Sita's purity and her fertile qualities, there's another instance that we can look at. When Hanuman lights fire to the entire city of Lanka, he thinks about the safety of Devi Sita in the fear that the fire may have consumed Ashokavana, right? Now, what happens is he tells, Tapasa satya vakyena ananyat tvacha bhartani apisa nirdahet agnim natam agni pradakshyati. What does he say? Goddess Sita can even burn away the fire by her penance. Tapasa satya vakyena ananyat tvacha bhartani. She can burn away the fire by her penance, by her true utterances, and by her undivided devotion towards her husband. The fire does not ignite her. Apisa nirdahet agnim natam agni pradakshyati. Now, in this context, it can be understood that her strong devotion to her husband, who is the lord of the world, he is capable of protecting her from all and any evils. Her penance and submission to her husband is sufficient to keep her untouched from any negative circumstances. Now, this kind of love can also be seen in Bhagavatam, wherein the Gopikas are completely surrender themselves to Lord Krishna. They're immersed in devotion. And there's also another instance where Uddhava is bewildered by their bhakti towards the Lord. He wonders how the Gopikas are so immersed in always thinking about Lord Krishna. Now, this is otherwise considered as bhakti yoga, and it is preached by Lord Krishna in Bhagavad Gita as well. To conclude, during the Mahabharata war, Arjuna had Lord Krishna as his charioteer, and all the other brothers, they placed Lord Krishna in their hearts, and thereby they won the war for Dharmasthapana. There is a comparison that can be drawn in this regard. If you look at this picture, our body is a chariot, and here the rider is the soul in which our body is traveling. Now, we travel on a certain path from adulthood, from childhood to adulthood. We travel through different paths in our lives. And when you're going through so many stages in your life, your senses are always going in different directions. Now, how do you keep all of them in control? With your mind, which is the reins that Arjuna is holding. Now, you need to have the willpower to control your senses. And where do you get your willpower from? From your mind, from your intellect. And you can only get that strength to control your mind when you place Lord Krishna in your heart, in your mind, in your heart. Basically, you have to keep him as your manoratham. That is, he is the ratham in your mind. And he himself will be a charioteer who will help in commanding our senses to reach the ultimate goal of Sayujyam, or being one with the God. So on a concluding note, we would like to recite Ramayana in just one shloka, which is also known as Ekashloki Ramayana.
आदौ राम तपोवनादिगमनं हत्वा मृगं काञ्चनं वैदेही हरणं जटायुमरणं सुग्रीवसंभाषणं बालीनिग्रहणं समुद्रतरणं लंकापुरीदाहनं పశ్చాద్రావణ కుంభకర్ణహననం విదత్తి రామాయణం.
Now various instances from Ramayana, they converge into the primary ideal of living up to our tradition, to our culture, and to the values of our Bharata Desham. Now it is our country alone, India, which holds such a rich heritage and a priceless treasure of the Shruti and Smriti, that is, the Vedas, the Puranas, the Upanishads, and various epics. Now one must not get carried away by the riches of other countries. A lot of people these days look towards the Western culture and they think that is much better and they start imbibing those values, and that is not the right way for all of us who are born in such a pious karma bhumi. Now in fact, even in Yuddhakanda, Rama himself says the following words after conquering the wealthy kingdom of Lanka. Api swarnamayi Lanka name Lakshmana rochate. What does he say? Lakshmana, even this golden Lanka does not appeal to me. Api swarnamayi Lanka name Lakshmana rochate. Janani janmabhumishcha swargadapi gariyasi. Even our mother and our motherland, even they are superior to heaven. Therefore, it is our utmost duty that we respect our motherland by protecting and practicing its age-old traditions, and we should also uphold its culture and heritage. And finally, we must thank our parents for giving us a chance to be born, for giving us a birth into this pious karma bhumi, and we should always serve them with all due respect. A small bhajan on Sri Rama.
राम जयम हरि राम जयम राघव ध्यान मेलोकमयम राम जयम हरि राम जयम राघव ध्यान मेलोकमयम राम सीतापति राघव मंत्र रम्य सुगुण सेव्य निरंतरं राम सीतापति राघव मंत्रं रम्य सुगुण गण सेव्य निरंतरं राम दया पर सुजन पवित्रं रवि कुल दशरद सुर मुर हरि जय राम जयम हरि राम जयम राघव ध्यान मेलोकमयम राघव ध्यान मेलोकमयम राघव ध्यान मेलोकमयम.
स्वामी वारिकी धन्यवादुलु. Our special thanks to Sri Lakshmi Mandata Garu. She has given her valuable help and you know, she made her efforts very fruitful. Thank you very much, ma'am. We also thank the audience for their time and support.